The Republic of Croatia Armed Forces is the military service of the Republic of Croatia. The President of the Republic of Croatia is the Armed Forces Commander-in-Chief and it administrates it in times of war by giving orders to the Chief of Staff, while their administration and the defense policy execution in times of peace is done by the government through the Ministry of Defense. This unified institution consists of land, sea, and air branches referred to as Croatian Army, Croatian Navy, Croatian Air Force and Air Defense. Croatian Armed Forces are charged with protecting the Republic as well as supporting international peacekeeping efforts when mandated by the NATO, United Nations and/or European Union. Strength. The total number of active military personnel in the Croatian Armed Forces stands at 17,500 and 6,000 reserves working in various service branches of the Armed Forces. Navy 2,000 personnel, Air Force 2,000 personnel, Army 12,500 personnel, Croatian General Staff and units under its direct command 1,000 personnel. Total available male manpower aged 16 to 49 number 1,035,712, of which 771,323 are technically fit for military service. Male citizens are now no longer subject to compulsory military service since January 1, 2008. However, the last generation of 2007 servicemen was also absolved of compulsory service by an act from then Minister of Defense Berislav Rončević. Budget. The Croatian military budget for the past 6 to 7 years was kept below 2% of GDP, a vast difference from the 1990s when defense expenditure represented a major stake in Croatian budgetary expenditure due to the Croatian War of Independence. For example, 1995 Croatian defense budget stood at 12.4 billion Croatian kuna or just over 12% of GDP, which was also the highest defense expenditure ever. Defense expenditures in recent years, although the budget has been decreased from year to year, the Croatian armed forces were able to maintain military readiness and to participate in major NATO exercises in Croatia and overseas. This downsizing of the armed forces has allowed for more funds to be allocated to modernization over the past few years, with an average of 1.6 billion kuna spent on modernization, infrastructure and construction of new facilities. Modernization, although sporadic, has provided the armed forces with desperately needed new equipment, albeit in insufficient quantities to maintain NATO levels, which should be remedied over the coming years. A long-term modernization plan, 2015 to 2024, has been published outlining overall goals and is available for download at the Ministry of Defense of Croatia website. According to earlier reports from the government, the Croatian armed forces are set to receive vitally needed new equipment, including a battalion of self-propelled howitzers, new infantry fighting vehicles, at least 8 brand new helicopters and a squadron of fighter aircraft. At the moment, the Croatian Air Force will keep 12 MiG-21 bis fighter aircraft, which received a general overhaul in Ukraine in order to keep them operational for another 4 to 5 years. Peter Zarinsky Military Academy. The Peter Zarinsky Military Academy acts as a school of higher learning responsible for training and educating future generations of military personnel. The academy consists of several schools, including Banja Sapjelica, Blago Zadro, Katarina Zrinska, the Officers Academy, and a school for non-commissioned officers. In all, the academy has at any time 300 full-time staff and is the only military academy in Croatia. Each year some 100 to 120 foreign nationals attend the academy. Commander. The Commander-in-Chief of all Croatian armed forces in peace and war is the President of the Republic. The Commander-in-Chief prescribes the organization of the Croatian armed forces at the proposal of the Chief of General Staff, with consent of the Minister of Defense. The armed forces consist of peacetime and wartime components. The peacetime component is composed of the active military officers, civil servants and employees in the Croatian Armed Forces, cadets, and conscripts serving a six-month national service and reservists when on military exercise. The wartime component of the armed forces includes all other reservists. The general staff is part of the Ministry of Defense in charge of commanding, training and use of the armed forces. It also has a number of units under its direct command, including the Special Operations Battalion, Honor Guard Battalion and several others. In peace, the commander-in-chief exercises his command through the Minister of Defense. In war and in cases where the Minister of Defense is not fulfilling his orders, the commander-in-chief exercises his command directly through the General Staff Commander. The Croatian Parliament exercises democratic control over the armed forces by adopting defense strategy, defense budget and defense laws. Special Forces and Honor Guard. Special Operations Battalion was founded on September 8, 2000 with the merging of the Special Combat Skills Center and some personnel from the 1st Croatian Guards Corps. The battalion has 300 men. Today, it is one of the most elite units of the Croatian military, as well as being one of the best trained and equipped special forces units in the region. The Croatian General Staff exercises direct command over the battalion, which thus elevates the unit to strategic level deployment for quicker reaction and overall better and faster response to tactical and strategic situations. Also, this means that members of all three branches of the Croatian Armed Forces can apply for selection. Other special operations units are the Military Intelligence Battalion and Special Military Police Company. The duties of an honor guard are performed by the Pokusno Zaštitna Bojna, located at Zagreb in the Tuskanac military base. Projects. A $3 billion modernization plan was proposed by the then Prime Minister Ivica Rakan of the SDP-led government in 2003, with planned modernization starting in 2006 and ending in 2015. However, it has been delayed in part due to the subsequent economic recession, but also due to serious corruption that has cost the Croatian mod several billion kuna since 2006. A new plan under the current Prime Minister Zoran Milanovic should define exactly how and what the Croatian armed forces should look like by 2023. A defense white paper was published in 2015 with emphasis placed on modernization of the army, proposed defense programs and updates, upgrades, army procurement of 126 Patria AMV 8x8 modular APC, IFV 2.25 billion kuna. All vehicles have been delivered so far, with 115 protector remote stations delivered in two batches under $38 million contract. The initial order for 8 out of 24 30mm RWS is yet to be made. The contract is valued at some $55 million and includes 30mm RWs and two Javelin, or Eurospike launches. Procurement of 94 IVCO LMV at a cost of 220 million kuna by late 2012. So far only 14 vehicles delivered, without any indication if the future 80 vehicles will be needed, because the army received over 200 new light armored personnel carriers from the US. Procurement of advanced artillery systems. Up to 18 by 155mm self-propelled howitzers are to be purchased before 2015 to replace obsolete US-1 self-propelled howitzers. The Croatian mod is negotiating an order for 18 PZH-2000 howitzers with the German army, value of the contract, $36 million. Procurement of 555-ton army trucks, 207.5-ton military trucks and 304WD vehicles. The program is in full swing and the first batch of MAN, Mercedes and IVCO military trucks was delivered. The Croatian army also ordered large numbers of new 4WD vehicles, Mercedes-Benz G-Class 120, Land Rover Wolf 60, Toyota Land Cruiser 50, Nissan Navara 50, and took delivery in 2005 to 2007. Croatia is negotiating with Germany over the purchase of 380 second-hand army trucks of various sorts. Cost of this program projected at 40 to 50 million kuna. Modernization of M84A and M84A4 Snajper MBTs and upgrade to M84D standard. Program is at a standstill and is unlikely to receive further funding due to high costs involved of nearly 20 million kuna per tank, but overhaul of existing fleet might be completed by the end of 2017 at cost of 120 million kuna. Introduction of new 5.56 mm NATO standard VHS assault rifle. Cost of program 200 million kuna. Scores of smaller programs, communication equipment, night vision capability, electronic sensors, NBC equipment, battlefield management systems and modernization of artillery systems with new sights and electronic fire control systems are planned. Air Force procurement of advanced short to medium range NATO SAM system. As of now, no real funding has been mentioned other than the statement that this project is a priority and current requirements call for one battery, although this might change in future as needs arise. Estimated value $50-70 million for new system. Alternately, a second-hand system might be obtained as a donation by the United States, in which case only the VAT cost will be incurred. Procurement of short-range SAM systems. No indication of what system or specifications other than a requirement for a range of up to 10 kilometers. Intent is for up to 3 batteries with 1 battery being ready by 2015-6. Total funding for this program hasn't been made public yet, but similar Western systems tend to be in range of $17-20 million per battery. Overhaul of MiG-21 fighters. Program is about to be completed at cost of 80 million kuna. 12 MiG-21 fighters modernized and overhauled in Ukraine. At this point, it was the cheapest alternative for the government, which lacked the funds for the purchase of new fighters. Purchase of an advanced fighter aircraft medium to long-term program. Purchase of up to 18 X-4.5-GENERATION fighters. Program costs 12 to 15 billion kuna. This program is planned as a long-term investment in the Air Force designed to provide the next fighter, with new fighters joining the Air Force around 2020 and after. Most likely candidates are the JAS-39E/F and the F-16E/F Block 60. MiG-21 fighters currently in service will by then no longer be able to be overhauled and thus extend their life in future due to the age and stress on their airframes. The purchase of second-hand aircraft is still a possibility going forward, but with the cost of second-hand fighters not far off from new fighters, it is not a likely option. Purchase of up to 8 Western-made helicopters for SAR, Medivac and ASW as well as MP. Cost of program not specified, but preferences for EC-135 helicopter had been stated because MUP recently purchased 2 such helicopters at cost of 50 million kuna for the 2. Additional mission equipment might increase the cost for first 4 EC-135 helicopters. However, ASW Mr. helicopters on the other hand might be a lot more expensive. Program cost first 4 helicopters 100 to 120 million kuna. Procurement of 4 additional ASW Mr. helicopters won't be feasible before 2020. Program cost for these 4 helicopters $170-180 million if as 565 are chosen. Purchase of replacement transport aircraft for AN-32B. This program is feasible after 2020 and would involve a purchase of 2 to 3 medium tactical transport aircraft, C-27J and CN-295 being most likely candidates. Program cost 550 to 580 million kuna for 2 aircraft feasible only after 2020. Purchase of up to 10 to 12 transport helicopters, replacing older Mil-8 and 17. The cost of overhauling these was questioned as to whether it was cost-effective to continue overhauling these older helicopters every few years, instead of purchasing brand new Western helicopters, with the government indicating that purchase of 10 new Western helicopters might be the only option after 2020. Most likely candidates are NH90 or AS-532. Program cost, 2.5 billion kuna. 10 recently purchased Milmi-171SH helicopters will continue on in their service with Croatian Air Force for at least another 20 years. Purchase of unmanned aerial vehicles, no quantity specified, but a purchase will be made to enforce Croatia's maritime zone and border controls as part of the EU-Schengen agreement, which Croatia plans to join in 2015. Program cost, 100 to 120 million kuna, half financed by the EU. Navy plans are still being worked on, but present plans call for a moderate expansion of the naval force. 10 new patrol boats, locally built, 42 meters in length, cost the program 750 million kuna, or 375 million for first 5 ships, first to enter service in 2015, with remaining 4 in 2016 and 2017. 2 new corvettes 80 to 125 meters in length, cost of program 3.0 billion kuna. Program is at standstill due to lack of funds, feasible only after 2020. Overhaul of existing 2 King-class fast attack crafts, including new engines. Cost of program 40 million kuna. 1 ship overhauled in 2010-11 and second should be done in 2014. Upgrade of the RBS-15 missiles. Cost of program 120 million kuna. 24 to 32 of the missiles on hand to receive an upgrade and overhaul by 2015-16, with remaining missiles being scrapped or sold. Overhaul of Sea Radar Falcon 2 Enhanced Peregrine program is being financed by US government at estimated cost of $8 million. Possible purchase of second minesweeper before 2020, although there are only indications that this might happen if funds can be allocated. Program cost 80 million kuna. Programs under revision: BVPM-80A Infantry Fighting Vehicle Replacement. Program is at a standstill and might no longer be an option. Croatian MOD stated that it will replace its M80s with a modern Western IFV when funds become available. Most likely contenders for this program are additional Patria AMVs in the IFV configuration. Arms exports. Croatia, as a small country, has a relatively well-developed arms industry that is highly competitive internationally with significant annual arms exports. In 2012, Croatia managed to export nearly 120 million euros. However, it has been reported in the New York Times that Croatia has been arming Syrian rebels with Croatian-manufactured arms used during the Homeland War. Arms Croatia no longer uses due to their obsolescence. Nevertheless, these arms played a crucial role in some significant rebel gains during 2012. As a result of these arms sales into this volatile region, the Croatian government ordered the immediate withdrawal of the Croatian UN Golan Heights contingent to avoid their being targeted in retaliation. In 2013, Croatia exported 143 million euros worth of arms. However, it is not clear if this also includes $36.5 million worth of arms Croatia exported to Jordan for Syrian rebels. Croatia was the top supplier of arms to Syrian rebels in 2013. But much of it through illicit channels and without Croatian government approval or knowledge, most of these arms were exported via Jordan. In 2014, Croatia arms exports have reached 1.5 billion Croatian kunas, or 200 million euros, or $257 million, the majority of exports being to NATO allies and Australia. In late 2014, the Croatian defense minister announced a major export deal to Iraq, including the state of Kurdistan. This agreement includes the sale of 20,000 VHS rifles, 150,000 complete sets of uniforms, helmets and associated equipment valued at 100 million euros. Croatian arms exports are growing steadily at 10-15% YoY and they're expected to reach 1.75 billion Croatian kunas in 2015 or around 230 million euros. Although much of the equipment exported is non-lethal, Croatian firms are well positioned on some major arms tenders in Middle East, supplying complex military hardware such as Patria AMV, including a newly developed 30mm overhead weapon station and said vehicles valued at €1.75 million. Kuwait, UAE and Saudi Arabia have been mentioned as potential customers, although so far no concrete contracts have been signed. Croatian firms are participating in Kuwaiti and UAE tenders for next APC programs, each valued at billions of euros. International cooperation. On April 1, 2009, Croatia joined NATO and on July 1, 2013 it became the 28th member of the European Union. The Croatian Armed Forces participate in many of the aspects of both organizations as well as actively participating in many United Nations peacekeeping operations worldwide. Gallery. Patria AMV, M84A4 main battle tank, D30 howitzer, Mi-171SH, Croatian MiG-21 and USF-14, Wings of Storm aerobatic team, Bombardier 415, Air Tractor 8802A, Helsinki-class missile boat, Kralj-class missile boat.